1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily Jean. I hope you guys are all having a spectacular day. Today, we are going to talk headshots. We are going to talk types of headshots. We're going to talk all things headshots. Oh. And we are going to talk headshot photographers in New York City or the tri-state area that I would recommend if you are looking for headshots on the lower price end or headshots on the upper price end. All things headshots. But before we get started, please don't forget to subscribe because it'll really support my channel. Okay, so let's talk about headshots. So headshots were always a thing for TV, film, musical theater, all that kind of stuff. But I feel like now more than ever, they're actually really much more important because everything is virtual. Everything you're submitting is online. So you really want a headshot that's going to capture their attention, but most importantly, show them who you are. I can't stress this enough. You do not want a glamour shot. You do not want a modeling shot. You want a headshot that looks like you, either A, looks like what you're going to look like on tape, or looks like what you're going to look like when you walk in the room. What do I mean by that? Okay, well, my hair is short right now, right? It's like shoulder length. I have long haired headshots or like longer hair headshots that if my hair were to grow out and I would look like that with my long hair, I have those. But right now I have short hair. So all of my headshots I had to get redone because I've got this short haired look and you have to look like yourself. The second thing is, for television and film, you can get headshots for certain looks, right? So if you're going for young, sexy, flirtatious girl, you can wear something a little more seductive that would make you look like that type. Or if you're looking for the brainy girl type, you can throw on your glasses. You know, just little hints, not anything crazy. If you're thinking more Mrs. Maisel, you can do a touch of a hairdo that looks like 1950s. If you're thinking SVU lawyer type, you know, put a blazer on. Little elements that can show that you're that type. But again, it's still you. For musical theater, I would 100% recommend, you know, do a straight hair, do a curly hair. Again, the main thing that I can say about headshots is you want it to look like yourself. I've been behind the table with my agent who looks at the headshot and says, this looks nothing like you. You know, you always want to try to stay up to date. The great thing is headshots can be financially expensive, but now we're not really having to print them as much. So, you know, you're saving money on the one end, but we'll talk about price point when I talk about the different photographers. So I made a little list of photographers that I would recommend for headshots in New York City or New Jersey. The first one I'm going to plug, because it's a shameless plug, is my sister. All of these links will be in the description box below, and you can go check out their website and their portfolio. My sister, Rebecca Phillips, you can go check her out at Rebecca Phillips Photography. She does headshots, she does dance shots, she does modeling shots, fitness portfolio, anything that you're really looking for, she can do for you. You can do in studio or you can do on location. And her price point, I'm going to give you the base price point for all these photographers. Her price point for a 1 hour session, unlimited looks that you could fit in an hour, is $200, which honestly, that's a very, very good price point for headshots. And if it's like a quick, like, hey, I just cut my hair, I just need an updated photo, $200. You can throw on different shirts if you want to. And you do all that for $200. So definitely go check her out. I would highly recommend. As you saw in the thumbnail, she has done all my pictures, all my dance shots, all my headshots. You can check all of that out on my website at emilygphillips.com. She's done all my pictures. So she's a great photographer. She's great to work with. And it's that lower price point if you're looking for that lower price point. The second person that I would recommend that I actually have been following a lot on Instagram is J Eagle Photography. And I'll put the handle here for Instagram. So you can go check out J Eagle Photography's website. Again, this is another good price point. So $250 for an hour and a half. And you get two looks, which is nice. You can do two looks for an hour and a half in studio. Obviously, these are all the base price points and they all go up from there. And some people do packages like dance shot, headshot combination. All of that information can be found on their website. This is just the base price point for you guys. So you get a general idea of how much headshots costs, and then you can look at their portfolio and see if that's a fit for you. So that's J. Eagle Photography. The next one I would recommend that's very popular right now is John Taylor Photography. Again, here is that Instagram handle. And this is $375 for a half hour with one look. That's a little expensive for a half hour in my opinion, but if you go and look at his portfolio, obviously he's really popular and so a lot of people are trying to book with him. He also does dance pictures, but his headshots are very unique and specific, and they all look like all the people that I've seen that have headshots with him, they look like themselves, so I would highly recommend him. Again, his starting price point is $375, a little more expensive, but you're getting good quality work, so another person that I would highly recommend. Now, these two gentlemen are on the higher scale spectrum, so if you're really wanting to just have a full-on session, I would recommend these two. Their pictures are outstanding. Everybody in the industry shoots with these two, but they are extremely expensive. So the first one is Justin Patterson. He does headshots, dance shots, and they call them style, style shots, whatever you really want to do. The base price point is $600 for 90 minutes. So you're getting more time and you get three looks. That's headshots. You can also change that up and do different, whatever you're kind of looking for. But again, $600 for 90 minutes and three looks. And the next one is Matt Murphy. Matt Murphy, he photographs every Broadway show. All of the stuff that you see for Broadway publicity, Matt Murphy has probably done those photo shoots. So, A, he's really high in demand, and his prices aren't even listed on his website. I think you have to, message him. So, obviously, they're going to be really, really expensive if you're looking for that, luxurious, high-end, almost, celebrity-type photo shoot. Matt Murphy is the guy to go to. Now, obviously, all of these people do dance photography as well. I'm going to do a separate video on dance photographers that I would recommend if you're looking specifically for just dance shoots. But those are my recommendations for headshots. I know this video was short and sweet, but I figured I didn't want to give you 10 people. I wanted to give you the top people that I would recommend that I think that are a good time and are professional and put out good quality work for not that much money. Headshots really can range from $200 to $1,500. It really just depends on your financial place and what you're looking for. And then, are you looking for one look quick, or are you looking for three looks? Are you looking to redo your whole image? Again, based on what you're looking for. And I would definitely go check out all of their websites, because you kind of want to get what kind of vibe of a headshot are you doing. Every photographer is different and they produce different work. I'm not saying one is bad or good, they're just different. So look at everybody's headshots, see what the style you're going for, reach out to them, check in, and see if you can schedule a shoot. I definitely think that it's something that every performer or professional performer needs to do, especially if you're going to be auditioning virtually. You really want to have a nice headshot that looks like you and that will catch the casting director's eye or the director choreographer's eye. So those are my recommendations. Please leave a comment below. Please go check out their websites and then message me to tell me that you booked a shoot, and I can't wait to see everybody's pictures if you're gonna go get some headshots taken. Before you go, please don't forget to subscribe because it'll really support my channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.